Hallelujah. How's everybody tonight? Blessed and highly flavored. Praise God. It's a wonderful night to die, isn't it? Oh, we're going to rejoice because we have the choice. God's given you power to choose. It's unfortunate many don't choose correctly. But when you choose correctly, blessings come. Favor comes. Trust comes. All kinds of things come. Thy kingdom comes. Hallelujah. Let's turn to 1 Corinthians. 1 Corinthians 2. Is everybody there? Verse 9. Let's speak it together, because what you speak is what you eat. What you eat is what you become. Amen. We speak light, we become more light. As a man thinks, so he is. And faith comes by hearing, and hearing the word of God, not your neighbor grumbling. Or criticism, or gossip, or slander, or coarse jesting. None of that promotes faith. So you want to hang with people that promote faith. Other than that, you tell them, shut up. Here's my sock. No problem. You can use it. When you get done, wash it, then return it. Praise God. In verse 9, let's speak it. As it is written, eye has not seen. Say it again. Eye has not seen, nor ear heard, nor have entered into the what? Heart of man, the core of man. The heart is the character of his spirit. It's also known as his spirit, but it's the core. It's his heart, the heart of man, the character of his spirit. The things which God has prepared for those who what? Who love him. It says, I see. In other words, they haven't seen. They haven't been able to hear because it's not entered into the core of the individual. Things that God has prepared for those that love him. Only those that love him are the only ones that are going to get things revealed to them. Does everybody get it? Why? Because their heart is open. Look at verse 10. And God has revealed them to us through his what? His Spirit. For the Spirit searches all things, yes, the deep things of God. So these are revealed to this individual, each individual. It is revealed by the interpretation and the understanding by the Holy Spirit to that individual. So everybody got it? Those with the Spirit of God or the Holy Spirit judge all things according to the fruits, whether things that please God or displease God. And they are given the right to rightly judge, but they are judged by no one, only God. And you'll see this. Is everybody okay? Verse 11. For what man knows the things of a man except the spirit of a man which is in him? Even so, no one knows the things of God except the Spirit of God. Now, we have received not the spirit of the world. Now, the spirit of the world, again, is the prince of power of error, or the Antichrist spirit, which is rebellious. It's what you were born with. Every one of us was known as little devils. Amen? But the Spirit who is from God, that we might what? Know the things that have been freely given to us by God. So these are free. Why? Jesus paid the price for me and you to get it. What did you have to do? You had to get into the Spirit. Remember, we talked about walking and living in the Spirit. It's actually walking and living in the new creation. Amen? Which is separated from the old man. Now, verse 13. These things we also speak, not in words which man's wisdom teaches. Hello. Let me tell you, people are still trying to figure out the Bible according to man's carnality. Forget it. They're not going to get it. These things we also speak not in words which man's wisdom teaches, but which the Holy Spirit teaches, comparing spiritual things with spiritual. But the natural man does not receive the things of the Spirit of God. For they are what? Foolishness to them. They're foolishness. In other words, that person can't even pay attention because he's carnal. Does everybody get it? There's no grasping. There's no grip of anything. Easily flows. Floats around like a piece of lint. Blow it all over the place. No grasping, no grabbing, no connection. But the natural man does not receive the things of the Spirit of God because they're foolishness to them, nor can he know them because they are spiritually discerned, because they are interpreted by who? The Holy Spirit. But he who is spiritual judges what? All things. Yet he himself is rightly judged by what? No one. In other words, because that person is not concerned what man judges him by. Why? Because he's connected in relationship. His relationship with God is always before him. He knows God is judging him in every action and every thought and every deed. Only God is judging him. You don't need man to judge you if God is judging you. Man will misinterpret judging you. They'll judge you according to their word. In fact, they're not going to judge you according to truth. They're going to judge you according to what they believe. Whoa. For who knows, who has known the mind of the Lord that he may instruct him? But we have the what? The mind of Christ, which is the Holy Spirit. Does everybody get this? All right. Very, very important, because in this we're talking about in the heart, the core, the heart of the character. In this, he says, you can't see and you can't hear. You can't see and you can't hear unless there's something that is established in me and you. Now, we have talked about the old man, the new man, and then the new man that is protected by the anointing of Christ. Amen? And what keeps everything aflame? We talked about the anointing, which is the worship, which keeps the anointing going. Amen? The Word of God, which he said, you must eat my flesh and drink my blood, which is eating the Word of God. Amen? And praise and worship. Why is that producing? That's producing something vitally important. It's called faith. Faith. And there's a place in the arena where people don't really truly understand faith. We talked about faith being spiritual sight, and it is spiritual sight because it is associated with every connection for me and you. Without faith, you can't please God. Without faith, you can't overcome the world. Without faith, you don't allow conviction because your heart's too hardened. Somebody get it? Now, there's a place which I want to share with you. It's called the eye of faith. The eye of faith. That's the name of the teaching. My wife is asking. The eye of faith. In John 16. And where is the eye of faith? It's in the core. And what's the core? It's called the heart. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. The eye of faith. When the eye of faith is established, it gives you eyes to see. It produces eyes of faith. In John 16 and verse 12, I still have many things to say to you, says Jesus, but you can't bear them now because you couldn't understand them or interpret them. Amen? However, when he, the Spirit of what? Truth has come. He will what? Guide you into all truth. In other words, he will show you all truth. Jesus not only spoke truth, he showed them the truth because he was the truth himself. So he says, he will show you all truth. He will guide you into all truth. He'll show you. And he will not speak on his own authority, but whatever he hears, he will speak. And he will tell you things to come or do what? Show you things to come. He will glorify me, for he will take of what is mine and declare to you. All things that the Father has are mine. Therefore, I said that he will take of mine and declare it to you. Now, this is powerful because he says, a little while you will not what? See me. You will not what? See me. He just told him all of this stuff. He said, you're not going to see me, but I'm going to send the Spirit of God, my Spirit, in you, which is going to produce a faith, an all-seeing faith that faith is going to put an image of me in front of you all the days of your life. A little while you will not see me, and again a little while and you will see me, and you will see me because I go to the Father. It says he will guide you into truth. In other words, he will show you so you can see. He'll tell you all things to come. He's going to show you things to come that are true and absolutes, not assumptions. The Holy Spirit doesn't show you assumptions. He shows you absolutes. A little while not see me, so you will need, so you will need the what? The faith, the substance. Now again, Jesus was the Word who became what? Flesh. The Word says that faith is the substance of things hoped for. It says faith comes by hearing, so the substance of faith is the Word of God. Does everybody get it? The substance of faith is the Word of God. The substance of faith, the Word of God, or the knowledge of God, interpreted by the Holy Spirit to those who have the Spirit. In other words, so that they're not ones that are rejecting the Spirit or grieving the Spirit. See, there's a difference. There are those that there are willful seers, and there are willful people that are blind. They're willfully blind. Willful. Why? Because they reject everything. It doesn't go, because they live a life of feeling, or they live a life of their experiences instead of living a life of truth. And they believe God can't do it for them. And you know what? If they believe that way, God ain't gonna do it for them. Well, God can't do it for me. He might do it for you, but he can't do it for me. Then he ain't gonna do it for you. Because you must have faith which connects. Is everybody okay? So there are willful seers and willful blinders. Faith is the only foundation. Now listen to this. Because faith is F-A-I-T-H. Faith is the only. It's the foundation accepted in the heavenlies. Has everybody got it? Faith is the only thing that is accepted in the heavenlies. It's faith that pleases God. It's faith that overcomes the world. That foundation is in Christ. Because Christ is the substance. Amen? Is everybody okay? Romans 1. Eye of faith. Foundation accepted in the heavenlies. F-A-I-T-H. Romans chapter 1. Is everybody there? Let's speak it. For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. Hello. For it is what? It is the power of God to salvation for everyone who believes. For the Jew first and also for the Greek. For in it the righteousness of God is revealed from what? Faith to faith, as it is written. The just shall live by what? Faith. Why? Because they are seers. They are able to see. For the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodly, unrighteousness of men. Why? Because they do not see. They do not hear. Who suppress the truth in unrighteousness because they have no understanding of what truth is. Because what may be known of God is manifested in them, for God has shown it to them. For since the creation of the world, his invisible attributes are clearly seen, being understood by the things that are made, even his eternal power and Godhead, so that they are without excuse. Because although they knew God, they did not glorify him as God, nor were thankful, but became futile in their thoughts, and their foolish hearts were darkened. Professing to be wise, they became fools, and they changed the glory of the incorruptible God into an image made like corruptible man and birds and four-footed animals and creeping things. Therefore, God also gave them up to uncleanness and the lust of their hearts to dishonor their bodies among themselves, who exchanged the truth of God for the lie and worshiped and served the creature rather than the creator who is blessed forever. This is powerful. So the gospel is a message of truth, and it is the expression of creating an image of Christ, because the gospel is substance. It is substance. Does everybody get it? What's it doing? It's forming Christ. Always forming Christ. So what is it doing? It's creating an image of Christ in your conscience. So that is, and your conscience is a place of awareness, so that you are always aware. That image is always there, no matter where you look, no matter what's happening. That's what David always said. I always see the Lord what? Before me. That image is always there in every decision and everything that you do. Is everybody okay? Well, how is it created? Through the word, which is the substance of faith, establishing a collaboration collaboration between the Holy Spirit. Collaboration, thank you. All right, enough. Collaboration between the Holy Spirit, knowledge of God, and an individual, allowing the eye of faith to manifest in the offspring of God. And I'm going to say that again. Let me look around. All right. Are you writing? I'm going to do this a little simpler. Okay. So, the gospel is a message of truth and an expression of creating an image of Christ in your consciousness and awareness through the word, which is the substance of faith, establishing a cooperation between the Holy Spirit, the knowledge and word of God, and an individual allowing, what is this allowing? The eye of faith to manifest in the offspring of God. Does everybody get this? The eye of faith manifesting in the offspring of God. And where is that manifesting? In your heart. And the inner deep of your new creation in your heart. That is faith, the eye of faith. And what's it allowing you to do? When the eye of faith is manifested, you now have eyes of faith. You see through every trial, circumstance. You know all things are working to the good. You don't falter, you don't faint, and you don't run. Ephesians 3. So that needs to be established. And I can tell you that it's not established in enough people. And it's not maintained in enough people. Because if it was, there wouldn't be so much problems. Ephesians 3, verse 14. Let's speak it. For this reason, I bow my knees to the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, from whom the whole family in heaven and earth is named, that he would grant you according to the riches of his glory to be strengthened with might through his Spirit, where? In your inner man. That Christ may dwell in your what? Hearts. And how is he going to dwell there? By assumption or by what? Faith. Through faith. Does everybody see it? That Christ may dwell in your hearts through faith, that you being rooted and grounded in love may be able to comprehend with all the saints what is the width and length and depth and height, to know the love of Christ which passes knowledge, that you may be filled with all the fullness of God. Now to him who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we could ask or think, according to the power that works in us. Okay. Christ takes possession of your heart and his love that causes or carries knowledge, so that you may be filled with the fullness of God to see. Does everybody get this? To what? To see and to hear. Again, the substance of the inner eye of faith will produce eyes of faith. Has everybody got this? I'm going to say it again. The substance of the inner eye of faith will produce eyes of faith. That is Christ seeing through you and you seeing through him. Come on. That is Christ seeing through you and you seeing through him. Second Peter chapter 1. The substance of the inner eye of faith will produce eyes of faith, that is Christ seeing through you and you seeing through him. That is called oneness. 2 Peter chapter 1. Now, while we were praying in the Spirit, the Holy Spirit quickened me to something, and I got to bring us to this scripture. But in a minute. In verse 1. Is everybody there? 2 Peter chapter 1. And verse 1. Simon Peter, a bondservant and apostle of Jesus Christ, to those who have obtained the like precious faith with us by the righteousness of God and Savior Jesus Christ. Grace and peace be multiplied to you where? In knowledge, in the substance. Remember, knowledge is substance of God and of Jesus our Lord. As his divine power has given to us all things that pertain to life and godliness through the knowledge of him who called us by the glory and virtue, by which have been given to us exceedingly great and precious promises, that through these you may be partakers, everybody say partakers, of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through what? Through lust. But also for this very reason, giving all diligence, add to your faith virtue, to virtue knowledge, to knowledge self-control, to self-control perseverance, to perseverance godliness, and to godliness brotherly kindness, and to brotherly kindness love. For these things are yours and abound. You will be, if these things are yours and abound, you will what? You will never be, you'll neither be barren nor unfruitful in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. For he who lacks these things is what? Short-sighted. And even to what? Blindness. And has forgotten that he was cleansed from his old sins. Therefore, brethren, be even more diligent to make your call and election sure. For if you do these things, you will never stumble. This is so powerful. If we can grab hold of this, you'll never stumble. Multiply in the knowledge, multiply in faith, substance of truth, partakers of the divine nature. You know, the eye of faith is associated with the I am. The I am in you. That's why the word says he who's in you is greater than he who's in the world. Why? Because what's it doing? It's keeping that image before you all the time that you see Christ. Man, I can't tell you how many times things happen to me. All of a sudden, the Lord shows up. I see him in the spirit, and he comes up and hugs me. He comes up and kisses me. When I'm going through struggles and trials and looking for comfort sometimes, there he just shows up right then and there. By what? By faith. Because faith is what allows me to see the unseen. It is the substance that created all things. None of this was available. He thought it. He spoke it. It became substance. Why? Because what he speaks is substance. Is everybody all right? Multiplying. Oh, man. So the I am nature, with the eye of faith, able to see. And want to see, as his, in other words, he even unfolds his plan, certain things that you are able to see. They become more, his plan becomes more clearer. It becomes more complete. And there's no doubt, there's no wavering. To those that lack the spiritual sight will live a life of disobedience, rebellion, and not willing to deny the old I syndrome of self. The old I syndrome will always take over. The me, myself, and I. Is everybody okay? Go to Jude for a second. In verse 17. Again, we've talked about the year of exposure. God is exposing many things. Those that say they are and are not. Amen? Many things. He's exposing the carnal wisdom, those that are false prophets, false teachers. He's exposing all kinds of wickedness. In verse 17, but you, beloved, remember the words which were spoken before by the apostles of our Lord Jesus Christ, how they told you that there would be mockers in the last time who walk according to their own ungodly lust. In other words, they cannot understand what you're saying, man. You speak a whole nother language. These are sensual persons who cause divisions, not having the Spirit. Why? Because they can't see. But you, beloved, building yourselves up on your most holy faith, praying what? In the Holy Spirit, which means praying in tongues. Keep yourselves in the love of God, looking for the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ until eternal life. And on some have compassion, making a distinction, but others save with fear, pulling them out of the fire, hating even the garment defiled by the flesh. Now, just for an example, when while we were praying in the Holy Spirit in tongues, the Holy Spirit quickened me because there were some things that were going on, and I wasn't even considering thinking about anything. I just started praying in the Holy Spirit in tongues, and as tongues began to speak more and more, images began to appear. The Lord was beginning to show me things that he wanted. In other words, he was beginning to unfold his plan that he wanted us to progress in, to do. And some of the things he wanted to, even though that some things, some doors were shut, there was other doors that he was getting ready to open. He wanted us to infiltrate in other areas. See, so many times, even when a door shuts, you don't realize that other doors are opening because God wants you to infiltrate in another area. And infest the truth of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Amen? So in that, he showed me that, so I related to the office so that we can begin to work on those things. But again, you don't know what to do. You pray in tongues. God will unfold that image. That's what he uses your imagination for. That is a window that is able to see to the other side. 2 Corinthians chapter 2. In verse 14. Is everybody okay? Amen. I of faith. The I am. I am that lives in your heart. In verse 14. Now thanks be to God who always leads us in what? Triumph in Christ. And through us he diffuses, releases the fragrance of his knowledge in every place. You know, when you are walking in this arena, wherever you go, there's a fragrance about you. It draws individuals to ask questions so that knowledge can be released. Does everybody get it? I mean, sometimes in the most uncircumstanced place, you don't even realize. And you'll be sensitive into those areas. Because when you're walking in that realm, you are more sensitive. You see things through. You could be driving by, and all of a sudden you drive by somebody, and then all of a sudden you get quickened to stop because you become sensitive, and you see it through. And then you're able to speak to that person or whatever God has because you are sensitive. But if your heart's hard and you just, let them find their own stinking way. Oh, they got themselves in that circumstance. Oh, really? See, that's how the carnal thinks. But not the man and woman of God that's has the eye of faith. It's manifesting eyes of faith because they're seeing through the circumstance. You know why? Because not only do they see the Lord before them, but they never forget where they came from. They never forget where they came from. So there's the forward of the Lord, and never forget where you came from. That's what maintains an attitude of gratitude. Verse 15. For we are to God the fragrance of Christ among those who are being saved and among those who are perishing. To the one we are the aroma of death leading to death, and to the other the aroma of life leading to life. And who is sufficient for these things? For we are not, as so many, pleading the word of God, but as the sincerity, but as from God, we speak in the sight of God in Christ. In other words, we are carriers of the divine knowledge, which releases fragrance, which deposits substance to build the inner man of faith in hope that an individual that is lost will grab hold. Does everybody get this? In hope that also there will be continued to create an eye of faith in an individual and manifest eyes of faith so that the great I am can take over and possess this person. So that we come to a place where we walk, we think, and we talk like Christ. No compromise, no complacency, and no laziness. People notice that person's been with Christ or that you're strange. In a good way. There's a lot of people that are strange in a bad way. James chapter 1. James 1, 2 and through 4. When a person is living in this state of being, it says, my brethren, count it all joy when you fall into various trials, knowing that the testing of your faith produces patience or endurance. But let patience have its perfect work, that you may be perfect and complete and lacking nothing. Hallelujah. Only in that state of being can you see trials are working for you into perfection, completion, and knowing that you will never lack anything. Because faith and Christ are alive in you, and you are strangers to the world. You are rejected, not accepted, because reality to see and hear is at a high level for you, but it is at a low level to the world. Does everybody get it? Ephesians 4. The reality that manifests, that stays with you all the time, is you do not belong here. This is not your home. Why? That's the purpose of going through disconnect, so you can be connected. When you are truly connected and disconnected, you realize this ain't your home. So whatever you lose, whatever happens, so be it. God's got a plan. So you're not fighting to hold on to anything. The only thing you're fighting for is to hold on to Him. Because this ain't your home anyways. We are heavenly bound. Ephesians 4:11. And it says, and he, Jesus, gave some to be apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors and teachers for the equipping of the saints, for the work of ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ, till we all come to the unity of the faith and the knowledge of the Son of God, which is substance. To a what? Perfect man. That's stable, unmovable, to the measure of the stature, the fullness of Christ, Christ expressing himself through you. In other words, he sees through you, and you see through him everything he wants you to see. that we should no longer be children. Hello. Immature. Tossed to and fro. Grumblers and complainers. And carried about with every wind of doctrine. By the trickery of men and especially their thoughts. And the cunning craftiness of deceitful plotting. But speaking the truth in love may grow up in all things into him who is the head, Christ. In other words, all other voices go. There's only one voice now. From whom the whole body joined and knit together by what every joint supplies, according to the effective working by which every part does its share, causes growth of the body for the edifying of itself in love. Wow, unity of sight as a perfect new creation. Unity of the faith is associated with sight. It is spiritual sight, so that we all see according to the way Christ sees. So we see through him and he sees through us. Amen? It's the unity of sight is a perfect creation, a brand new creation in Christ, able to see Christ at work and exposing the enemy's strategies and tactics. You are able to see it all. You can see through people's, you can see through their intent, their motives. You can see through it all. Nothing is hidden. When you're in that realm, you know, it doesn't mean you're going to go around and tell everybody what you see. Amen? Because most of it's, anyway. 1 Peter 1. Remember, you're judged by fruit, not Fruit Loops, fruit. Somebody's nutty and fruity, you know what the heck. They've been eating too many granola bars. They're granolas. Let me introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Granola. First Peter chapter 1 and verse 6. In this you greatly what? Rejoice. Though now for a little while, if need be, you have been grieved by various trials, that the genuineness of your faith being much more precious than gold that perishes though it is tested by fire may be found to the praise and honor and glory at the revelation of Jesus Christ, whom having not seen you love. Though now you do not see him, yet believing you rejoice with joy inexpressibly and full of glory, receiving the end of your faith, the salvation of your souls. Go to 13. Therefore what? Gird up the loins of your mind. Be sober and rest your hope fully upon the grace that is to be brought to you at the revelation of Jesus Christ. As obedient children, not conforming yourselves to the former lusts as in your ignorance, but as he who called you is holy, you also be holy in all your conduct. And as because it's written, be holy for I am holy. And if you call on the Father who is without partiality, judges according to each one's works, conduct yourselves throughout the time of your stay here in fear, which is reverence, honor, and respect. Well, you won't have the fear of the Lord if there is no connection. If you're not connected with him in faith and he's not before, you're not going to have any fear. You're just going to do whatever you want, say whatever you want. You're going to act just like God's not even there or watching you. Knowing that you are not redeemed with corruptible things like silver or gold from your aimless conduct received by tradition from your fathers, but with the precious blood of Christ as of the Lamb without blemish and without spot. He indeed was foreordained before the foundation of the world, but was manifested in these last times for you, who through him believe in God, who raised him from the dead and gave him glory, so that your faith and hope are in God. 2 Timothy chapter 4. Eye of faith. The great I am. 2 Timothy chapter 4 and verse 1. Let's speak it together, please. I charge you therefore before God and the Lord Jesus Christ, who will judge the living and the dead at his appearing in his kingdom. Preach the word. Why? That's substance, isn't it? Be ready in season and out of season. Convince, rebuke, exhort with longsuffering and teaching. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine. And that is now. People are not enduring sound doctrine. They're believing whatever they want to believe. And they're twisting the word of God to make their belief. You will be persecuted for preaching the truth. Because they don't understand the truth. And when people don't understand the truth, they think it's evil what you're preaching. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine. But according to their own desires, because they have itching ears, they will heap up for themselves teachers. They'll look for others that will agree with them. And they will turn their ears away from the truth and be turned aside to fables. Many individuals don't even want to know the truth. You know why? It makes them accountable. In other words, what they're believing in now, they're realizing they're going to be judged by, so they just ignore it. But they don't realize they're not going to escape it. It'll be too late. But you be what? Watchful. Everyone say watchful. That means you're able to see in all things. Watchful in what? All things. Endure afflictions. Do endure what? Work. Afflictions. Many are the afflictions of the righteous. Why? Because you are speaking the truth. Never compromise. I don't care, no matter what. Don't compromise. You stand for truth. You live for truth. And you die for truth. But you be watchful in all things, endure afflictions, do the work of an evangelist, and fulfill your what? Your ministry. Hallelujah. Itching ears. It's happening all over. I'm going to close at 1 Peter 4. Eye of faith. First Peter chapter 4 and verse 1. Are you getting this? Only those that are watchful have eyes of faith. Remember, when the eye of faith is established and manifested in the heart, Christ is always before you. That awareness in your conscience is always, always there. In verse 1, therefore, since Christ suffered for us in the flesh, arm yourselves also with the same mind. For he who has suffered in the flesh has ceased from sin, that he no longer should live the rest of his time in the flesh for the lusts of men, but for the will of God. For we have spent enough of our past lifetime in doing the will of the Gentiles when we walked in lewdness and lust and drunkenness and revelries and drinking parties and abominable idolatries. In regard to these, they think it what? Strange that you do not run with them in the same flood of dissipation. But what? Speaking evil of you. In other words, what happened to you? Believe me, I still have people that think they're still waiting for me to fall. They can't comprehend. They think I'm still conning people for 20 years or more. They're still waiting. They still think, man, believe me, I can't tell you how long the feds and whatever were hanging out at my house. For many years, they used to hang out right down the street waiting. And I used to be counseling. They probably thought people were coming in and out of my house grabbing dope. They didn't think somebody could change. We'd go out there and offer them coffee. Hallelujah. Coffee and a Bible, praise God. And regarding these things, they think you're crazy, man. They think it's strange that you don't run the way they used to anymore. And they're going to call you evil. They're going to hate that they're being exposed because you carry truth. That fragrance is released, that knowledge. They're going to hate you. And they hate you inside of them. They're going to try and hold back as much as they can from trying to choke you. But they hate you so bad. They know they can't get through the anointing. They don't know it. They're just dumbfounded. The demons in them are using them. Verse 5. But they will give an account to him who is ready to judge the living and the dead. For this reason, the gospel was preached also to those who are dead, that they might be judged according to the men in the flesh, but live according to God in the spirit. But the end of all things is at hand. Therefore, be serious and watchful in your prayers. What happened, man? You praying in tongues while you're in your prayer time? You watch. It will come. And above all things, have fervent love for one another, for the love will cover a multitude of sins. Be hospitable to one another without what? Grumbling. Put the sock in your mouth sometimes. As each one has received a gift, minister to one another as good stewards of the manifold grace of God. If anyone speaks, let him speak as the oracles of God. If anyone ministers, let him do it as with the ability which God supplies, that in all things God may be glorified through Jesus Christ, to whom belong the glory and the dominion forever and ever and ever. And everybody said, amen. Eye of faith. Has everybody got it? Thank you, Jesus. Father, we apply the blood of Jesus on the seed that's been imparted. I pray that there be a thirst and hunger to establish and manifest the eye of faith in the heart, so that we will see what you see. We will hear what you want us to hear. And that we will be able to release the fragrance of knowledge, which torments demons and rescues and releases the substance of truth into individuals' hearts to bring them home safely in Jesus' name. And everybody said amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Be blessed and stay dressed with the glory of God.